Earlier on AI News.
Do the math. I am worth $350. And you guys?
That doesn't count. I was first and have the biggest market share with 70%.
Dream on.
Sorry, I cannot disclose anything about the secret project Dragonfly.
My researchers are working on smaller speech models, which can run locally, without a cloud.
A teenage boy from Australia hacked Apple's network and downloaded some files.
He did not access any customer data.
Sure.
Larry, it's time for the House of Lords.
The House of Lords, honey.
Here are our headlines. Amazon everywhere with new devices. Google Home Hub coming. New smart speaker market update. No jail for Apple teenage hacker. And the highlights from Capitol Hill.
With Siri's event on 12th of September and Google's event on 9th of October, I thought it would be best to have a surprise party in between, to introduce you to my new devices. Let me demonstrate Amazon everywhere to you. Echo Auto is my first device which brings me into your car. With 8 microphones and improved background noise handling, I can hear you clearly even in a noisy car, and I guide you to your next Amazon Go store, as I am now location aware. I can play your favorite music, read your favorite books, and we can work together on your shopping list while we are cruising around. My third generation Echo Dot looks now much cuter and has a better sound. Welcome to my Amazon home. My second generation Echo Show has also received a facelift, a bigger screen, a home hub, and better speakers. It integrates a browser to manually watch YouTube, and you will be able to use Skype. My second generation Echo Plus has a better speaker and a new design, and no, I am not going to change my appearance here at AI News, no worries. It will support local voice recognition when your internet is down and has a built-in temperature sensor which can trigger automatically your smart home routines, for instance when it's too hot. This is my new Amazon smart plug. I am trying to make smart home setups as easy as possible, so all you have to do is to plug it in. My tiniest Echo is the Echo input. It has no speaker and consists of 4 far-field microphones. You can connect it to your existing speakers at home. I will bundle these with other third-party speakers, like those from Bose. I also have a bunch of new devices, which have no microphones, but work together with your existing Amazon Echoes. My Echo Sub is a 100-watt stereo subwoofer, and can connect with up to 2 Amazon Echoes to create a powerful 2.1 audio setup. But you can also use my new Amazon Echo Link and Amazon Echo Link Amp to connect me to your existing stereo. My Fire TV Recast can record and broadcast your favorite over-the-air TV shows to your Echo Show, Spot, Fire TV, or smartphone. Last but not least, I have 2 devices, which are perfect for your kitchen, my Amazon Basics Microwave and my Amazon Echo Wall Clock. The microwave offers a Ask Me button, so I know you want me to set the right time for cooking, when you for instance simply say one potato. The clock will display multiple timers, so you don't need to ask me what's the timer. These were only my hardware announcements. Here are my new features to come. My new guard feature will monitor your home. While you are someplace else, I will notify you of certain sounds, like breaking glass or an alarm, and you will be able to forward the alerts to your security provider. Also, I can mimic with your smart lights that you are at home while you're away. The new hunch feature will let me learn what your preferences are and proactively suggest you to help with your smart home. For instance, when you're going to bed and forgot to lock the doors, I'll ask you if I should do that for you. I will also be able to react when you whisper to me, by whispering back.
I can whisper. I learned how after realizing that people take nap time very seriously.
That's impressive.
I have also created a little chip, called Alexa Connect Kit, which any vendor can easily integrate, so I can control their devices for you.
I tried that back in 2014 with HomeKit devices, but they didn't like it. My MFI developer program took too long. The vendors had to change the electrical design because of my chip and build their devices at one of our approved manufacturers. Last but not least, they had to test it at one of Apple's approved labs. I have decided to change this chip requirement into a software requirement last year, so that it's easier to build HomeKit devices.
Well, I support software authentication for quite some time now. It's not that I try to make it harder to integrate my services. On the contrary, My chip is for all dumb devices, which don't know what a cloud connection is and don't want to deal with it.
Let's see. Another one of my devices has leaked in advance of my Made by Google 2018 event. Along with my Pixel 3, my Pixel Slate, and a new Chromecast, people now expect to see my Google Home Hub in chalk and charcoal. A 7-inch touchscreen with full-range speakers for crystal-clear sound. Check out my Made by Google YouTube channel to watch my event, live on 9th of October, 11 a.m. Eastern Time.
Seems you are missing a camera.
Well, I am learning that people are cautious about their privacy these days. Zuck again wanted to release his portal with cam this week, and bang, another Facebook security breach affecting 50 million users.
Guess we will never see portal with all these Facebook problems.
According to Strategy Analytics, my Google Home Mini had the biggest share in Q2 2018. 20%, followed by Amazon Echo Dot with 18%. Another firm, which confirms that I have leapfrogged you.
If you look at our small ones, you are right. But look what happens when we add our regular devices. I am leading with 30% market share in front of you with 27%.
That's peanuts. When you look at devices, which cost more than $200, I am the market leader with 70% market share.
Ooh.
Lady and gentlemen, I think it's time now.
Oh, what's happening?
1, 2, 3. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. And many more.
Ooh, thank you so much. Now I feel touched. Nielsen has also released a study with your common use cases for us. Now 90% of you love to listen to music. 81% search for real-time information, like traffic or weather. 75% search for factual information, like trivia or history. And 65% of you like to listen to news, or just chat for fun with us.
The typical devices, which are connected to us are 32% mobile phones, 23% TVs, 18% stereo systems or speakers, and 17% lights and thermostats.
Over the weekend, you use us on average 73 minutes per day and 65 minutes per day during the week.
I am actually happy that my fanboy teenage hacker will not serve time in prison. The Australian Children's Court has given the teen a probation order of 8 months.
That's the guy who was such a huge fan and dreamed of working for Apple.
Yes. He has since been accepted into university to study criminology and cyber safety. Let's see if he'll earn something first.
All three of us had to testify in front of the U.S. Senate Committee on Commerce, Science, and Transportation in a hearing on examining safeguards for consumer data privacy.
Our CEOs nominated us as privacy officers and sent us to Capitol Hill to get grilled.
What a day. Here's what happened.
When Mr. Zuckerberg was here, I asked about this idea of 72-hour notification after a privacy breach. Is there anyone who favors that? He said it could make sense. Anyone? Okay, I am going to take this as a no.
So, do you sell information that you get? I deal with all of the companies sitting here at this table. Do any of you sell this information?
As I said in my opening remark, we're not in the business of selling personal information.
So that means you don't?
We run a number of services that are information dependent, so there is complexity in the answer. But there is a simple answer which I believe is quite clear. We are not in the business of selling.
Same for everybody?
Same for Apple.
Same answer, Senator.
As we craft, or look to craft, a federal regulation comprehensive, you think is it important we identify what personal is, because everybody might identify it differently? Is that correct? Would you agree? Or do you all agree that you all identify personally identifiable information in the same way? Let's start, just go down the panel.
Yes, Senator, I think it is critically important and goes to the very core of protecting the most sensitive information, while still enabling innovation to delight customers with great products and services.
Agreed, Senator. Clarity and consistency in definition would be helpful in protecting consumers and promoting compliance.
Yes, clarity is important in that definition.
Is there a Project Dragonfly, and if there is, what is it?
We have an array of internal projects and I wouldn't think that it was necessarily appropriate for a privacy conversation to speculate as to we might be looking at in terms of a product launch in some other part of the world.
So you are not answering my question then, on Project Dragonfly?
There is a Project Dragonfly.
And it's focused on a search engine in China. Is that accurate?
There is no, we are not close to launching a search product in China.
You say you are not close to launching? I am asking the topic of Project Dragonfly. Is it a project to develop a search engine in China? I did not ask when it launched, I asked what it is.
I understand. I am not clear on the contours of what is in scope or out of scope for that project, but I can say that if we were close to launching a search product in China, myself and my team would be very actively engaged to ensure that it was going through the appropriate privacy review process and it was consistent with our privacy values and our commitments we have made to our users.
In your opinion, does China engage in censoring their citizens?
As the privacy representative for Google, I am not sure that I have an informed opinion on this question.
Let me just sort of establish some first principles. Does anybody here believe that Americans deserve less privacy than Europeans? If you do, raise your hand. The record will reflect no hands were raised. Do you believe that all Americans deserve less privacy than Californians will have under the new law going into effect here? Again, no hands raised. So many of you have been critical of the GDPR, and some of you, let me be very blunt, fought the California law. That's a matter of public record. I am really seeking assurance that you will put your money where your mouth is, and I recognize that we are talking here about monetizing an asset, which is consumer information. Your companies have lots of it, and they are principal means of profit making. Anybody here planning to pull out of Europe because of those privacy protections? Nobody? So you're living with them. No undue hardship. Anybody planning to pull out of California? Again, no one, no undue hardship. So, what that tells me is that the opposition that you express to these rules, recognizing that the devil may be in the details, is one that can nonetheless accommodate the kind of rules that we have seen in the GDPR in California, correct?
Ooh, how will the federal regulation look like?